Judge Hirsch, may I respond to your question about the standard of review? The standard on the writ of certiorari is not quite as cramped as counsel would have it. The cases cited in my petition show that in reviewing commission or board action in cases of this kind, that it is a matter of right to take the proceeding. It is not discretionary, and it is more akin to a plenary appeal. That's the GBB case versus Broward County cited in the petition.
Here's my concern. Not so much the standard of the U.S., which is ample law. I know no shortage of cases for that. I want to have some understanding of what has meant by cause. I see the force of your argument. You say that the charter contemplates the job of chief is such an important job, such a serious job, that cause has to be shown. Is that a good cause? Is it any non-frivolous, non-frivolous cause? What cause? What if the city manager says, look, he gets on my nerves?
That would not be cause. There is a code section that enumerates some examples of cause, such as incompetence, but has a catch-all phrase for other good cause shown. I think, if you excuse me for just one moment here, I think it's important to come back to the cause that was specified by the
city. I agree with you. Mr. Greco would say the cause is insubordination.
That's not what the charge says. But by
Miguel, in summary.
Well, if I could get you to look at tab B to the petitioner's appendix, what it says is that you directed three police staff officers in your administration to strip of all responsibilities, thereby circumventing my express directive to hold up on their demotions. There's nothing there about status quo, nothing there about freezing them in place. The instruction was no demotions, and the chief complied with it. His August the 5th email, if you read it carefully, that's tab C. I think it shows you that the chief is clearly deferring to the city manager, not defying him, because he's saying, you put these restrictions on me, I would ask you to please revisit this and give me a date certain when I can terminate, I'm not sorry, when I can demote these three staff members by rolling them back from their commander position to their civil service ranks. So,
the question seems to be, Mr. Wisotsky, is not did he comply, but was there a basis in fact upon which quasi-judicial body whose actions we now review could find that he didn't comply?
Well, if you pitch it solely as a question of fact, it looks more restrictive, as you suggest, but it's also a question of law. In other words, the three-part standard for the grant of certiorari is lack of competent substantial evidence, or departure from the essential requirements of the law, or procedural due process violation. So we clearly have number one, if you file with the city code, but even if you don't agree with that, we have a departure from the requirements of the code. It says that a demotion is a reduction of classification. So there would be grounds for the writ right there. Also, the five day violation would also be grounds for the granting of the writ. Now, in response to City Council's argument that the five-day rule was split between commencement and adjudication, if that interpretation were adopted, what would happen? What would happen is start within 5 days and then let the proceeding drag on month after month, adjournment after adjournment, continuance after continuance, bringing out the very problem that the five-day rule was intended to resolve. You know, this thing went on and on and on. They crammed 3 or 4 hours of trial testimony into a 14-hour proceeding. With filibusters and various political dossiers that didn't need, on matters far beyond the scope of this proceeding, such as the robbery rate in the city of Miami in recent months. or the fact on the other side that the department won awards. It didn't. It's not an unreasonable construction to say you have an administrative hearing for cause, good cause shown and specified, and you have a brisk proceeding within the 5 days to bring about the determination, to render judgment as the 5-day rule says.
You have a minute.
Well, I ask if there are any questions of counsel, and we thank the court.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Blake.